Hi, I'm Benjamin Siegel.
And I'm Akiva Martyr.
And this is Shield News with your Week at a Glance.
With Pesach fast approaching, students will have time off to digest all the YU news they've been hearing the past few weeks.
Biggest of all for YU students was President Joel's recent announcement that faculties at Yeshiva College and Stern College for Women would be combining. At a town hall meeting on the Barron campus last week, the university administrator went into greater detail about this change and addressed other hot topics in the university.
But before we get into that, let's take a look at some of the most relevant news that's played out over last month.
Only a few weeks ago, students reported rumors that major cuts were looming for the Yeshiva College curriculum. The Yeshiva College Student Association, led by its president, Shai Berman, organized a student forum where students had the chance to write and sign a declaration of principles they later used as talking points in a meeting with the university president. Speaking of President Joel, he emailed students in an attempt to reassure their fears, but confirming that cuts would take place.
Soon after, it was faculty who publicly joined the discussion, passing a resolution that gave a vote of no confidence to President Joel. An administrative response was swift, as YU students received an email from the Board of Trustees backing President Joel and letting them know these decisions belong to the board. Male students awaited the semester's town hall meeting on the men's campus, while female students had the chance to sign up to join an informal meeting with the provost and president that same day. There, President Joel gave the biggest news of all.
We left off telling you last week that Dean Karen Bacon, the current head of Stern College for Women, would be leading the effort to consolidate faculties of the male and female undergraduate schools. But later in the week, he shed more light on the topic at another town hall meeting, this time on the Barron campus.
While President Joel addressed a number of topics, he began much the same way he did at last week's, talking about you. He mentioned his care for the student population and then opened the floor to questions. Students focus less on the faculty merger, with most questions pertaining to more specific matters. The future of computer science majors at Stern College, the fate of scholarship funds, and the religious leadership at the two campuses were just a few of them. Overall, it seemed both Joel and the students are exhausted of talk of the faculty consolidations. With Pesach fast approaching, we'll see if that remains to be true.
And now to Kaylin and Abigail for events.
Hi, I'm Kaylin Shahan.
And I'm Abigail Adler.
With Pesach coming up, you might think there aren't many events this week.
But don't worry, we've got you covered. The Stern Film Club will show Send in the Clowns Monday night in Yugoda Commons, a short film directed by Stern student Carmel Daneman. The screening will begin at 8 and will be followed by a Q&A with Carmel, and students can hear tips for crowdfunding campaigns about what goes on behind the scenes.
The YU Student Medical Ethics Society is hosting Money, Money, Money in Medicine. The roundtable discussion will focus on the ethics of, you guessed it, money in medicine. The event will be held in the Sky Caf and will feature questions like, how much do doctors make and how much should they make? Can patients pay for special treatments? And what's the halachic stance? Find out at 7:30 p.m. on Monday night.
Or you could come to First 501 at 8 p.m. to hear from the CEO of one of Israel's biggest investment banks and the president and founder of an Israeli strategy group. Leonard Rosen of Barclays Israel and Gidi Grinstein will be speaking in Israel Beyond the Apps. The two top business players in Israel will speak about trends and the business landscape in their country. This is an event you won't want to miss.
With all these events and speakers, you may want to mark your calendars for an exciting trip.
The Junior Six Flags trip is finally here. Students from all classes are welcome and can sign up through a link in your student email. The annual trip will be Sunday, April 19th.
This will be my last week with Shield, but it won't be my last time at YU events. For more, check out yu.edu/events.
Well, that's it for this edition of Week at a Glance.
Be sure to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
I'm Akiva Martyr.
And I'm Benjamin Siegel.
And you're watching
Shield News.